Radio 2 presenter Jo Whiley has vented her fury after she was offered a COVID jab before her disabled sister, who has now tested. The DJ, 55, told BBC Radio 4's Today program that it was mind-boggling she had been offered a vaccine before her sister Frances, 53, who has learning difficulties, diabetes and lives in a care home. Frances has CRI2CHAT, which is a genetic syndrome that is present from birth and causes delays. It means Frances should get her jab as part of priority group 6, ahead of sister Jo, whose age puts her. Frances had previously lived at home, but Jo said it became clear she needed to be in a home surrounded by people her own age and who have similar abilities. Speaking on BBC Radio 4's Today program, Jo said she feels as though she has been living through a nightmare. During the program, presenter Simon confirmed that Frances had tested positive for COVID-19, after Jo revealed her younger sister was being tested daily at the facility. Jo said, "It feels like it's been a very long time for the vaccine to get to her, and on Thursday night I got the call that I'd been dreading and Therese that saying they have about your blood running cold. We found out that COVID had hit their care home. There was an outbreak of COVID and she'd been due to come home and be with mom and dad, and that she has to stay where she is." Jo went on to explain that her sister is at risk from COVID and told how the family had hoped her test was negative and that everyone in the home would be okay. She added that she found it hard to understand why her sister had not yet received. So far in the UK, over 15 million people have received either the Oxford/AstraZeneca jab or the Pfizer/BioNTech jab, with over 500,000 having received a second dose. People in care homes and their carers were at the top of the list when it came to the first rollout of vaccine. What is CRI2CHAT? It is a chromosomal condition that happens when a piece of chromosome, CRI2CHAT, gets its name from a characteristic cry in infants. It sounds similar to immune. This is due to problems with the larynx and nervous system, but is usually gone by the age of 2. Other symptoms include feeding problems, low birth weight, unusual facial features and cognitive disability. The condition affects an estimated 1 in 50,000 and is more common in females. Jo said the care home and her family have done everything they can to try and get the jab into the home for the people. Through social media, she has urged her followers to sign a petition urging local MPs to stand up for people with learning difficulties when it comes to receiving the COVID jab. To add to her heartbreak, Jo revealed that she had now been offered the jab herself, before she said that Frances is in vaccine group 6, but that she also has diabetes, a condition that Jo says should bump her. Jo added, "I would have thought that she should have been vaccinated, she should have got it, but that doesn't happen. I want to speak up for people in care homes, like Frances, who have been overlooked, as this happens so often with people with learning disabilities. I can't tell you how frustrating it is and how horrendous it is at the moment. It's the stuff of nightmares. I feel like I'm living through a night. The whole weekend has been awful. It's been really, really difficult. And then ironically I got a message to say I was due to have a vaccine before my sister, who has learning difficulties and underlying health. So figure, I honestly don't know why I have been called. I think it might possibly be because I've been deemed it. My mind is boggling. It really is. I would give up my vaccine if I could in a heartbeat for my sister and any of the residents in the. It doesn't feel right." Jo added that the pandemic has been tough on her sister's mental health, as she is unable to understand why her family are unable. She said, "She's gone into quite a slump. She refused to speak to my parents over the weekend for the first time in her entire life, the first time in 53 years. She didn't want to speak to anyone. She's quite angry and confused. I'm used to her calling me 30 times a day. She's not calling me anymore, and that's quite." Just yesterday, NHS England moved into the next phase of the jabs rollout, stating that over 65s and adults with underlying health conditions would now be invited, but it's down to local health teams to make their own way down the path. This, however, can only happen if they have tried to contact people in the at-risk.